गुड मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रन, लेट अस कंटिन्यू विद चैप्टर नंबर 10, लाइट रिफ्लेक्शन एंड रिफ्रैक्शन। एंड लास्ट टाइम वी स्टडीड अबाउट रिफ्रैक्शन, लॉज ऑफ रिफ्रैक्शन, स्नेल्स लॉ, एंड नाउ विल बी स्टडीइंग अबाउट स्फेरिकल लेंसेज। सो लेट अस स्टार्ट। व्हाट आर स्फेरिकल लेंसेज? अ स्फेरिकल लेंस इज अ ट्रांसपेरेंट मटीरियल बाउंडेड बाय टू सर्फेसेस, वन or both of which are spherical. So we have two types of spherical lenses. It is convex lenses and concave lenses. So let us understand what are convex lenses. A convex lens is thicker in the middle and thinner at the edges. As you can see here, this first diagram, it is thicker in the middle and it is thinner at the edges, upper edge and lower edge, it is thinner. Rays of light parallel to the principal axis after refraction through a convex lens meet at a point on the principal axis. Now let us talk about principal axis first. What is principal axis? Principal axis is a straight line passing through the center of the lens. So that center of lens is known as optical center. Optical center is denoted by the letter O. So these are the rays of light which are parallel to the principal axis, and you know, after passing through the lens they join at a point, and that point is known as the focus, or it is also known as principal focus. And this lens is known as converging lens because all rays of light, they converge after passing through the lens. Whereas on the other hand, a concave lens, it is thinner in the middle and it is thicker at the edges. Look here, it is thinner in the middle and it is thicker at the edges. And here what happens, the rays of light which are parallel to the principal axis, they diverge. So that's why this lens is known as diverging lens. They scatter actually. So they diverge after passing through the lens, and it appears as if these light rays, they are coming from a point, and that point is known as the principal focus or the focus of this lens. And it lies on the same side where the object is present. So as it is clear from these two diagrams that in case of convex lens, the principal focus, that is on the right side of the lens, whereas in this side, in this case, that is concave lens, the principal focus is on the left side of the lens. Now what are the rules for refraction by spherical lenses? We will be learning about three rules, and based on these three rules we will be drawing ray diagrams. There will be six ray diagrams of convex lens and there will be two ray diagrams of concave lens. So let us start learning about the rules first. First rule: in a convex lens, a ray of light parallel to the principal axis after refraction passes through the focus on the other side of the lens, whereas in a concave lens it appears to diverge from the focus on the same side of the lens. Now what does it mean? Now look here, this is a ray of light which is parallel to the principal axis. After refraction it will pass through focus. This focus is F2 here. On the other hand, this is a ray of light parallel to principal axis in case of concave lens. And what happens when it passes through concave lens? Look here, it diverges and it appears as if it is coming from the focus F1. So this is first rule. So whenever you draw a ray of light parallel to principal axis, then it will pass through focus, or it appears as if it is coming from the focus. Second rule: in a convex lens, a ray of light passing through the focus after refraction goes parallel to the principal axis. So this rule, second rule, is actually just opposite to the first rule. Here, the ray of light is already passing through the focus, and after passing through the focus, it becomes parallel to the principal axis. So, look here. This is a ray of light passing through focus F1 of convex lens, and after refraction, it will become parallel to the principal axis. Whereas, what happens in case of concave lens? This is a ray of light which is directed towards the focus, and it becomes parallel to the principal axis. So, in this case, in second case, in concave lens, the ray of light, it is directed towards the focus, and it also becomes parallel to the principal axis. Whereas, in this case, in case of convex lens, the ray of light which is passing through the focus, it becomes parallel to the principal axis. Third rule, in a convex lens and concave lens, a ray of light passing through the optical center goes without any deviation, without changing its path. This is a ray of light passing through optical center, and it goes without deviation. There is no change in its path. Similarly, in case of concave lens also, a ray of light which passes through the optical center, that goes without any deviation. Now you will be surprised, what is this F1, F2, 2F1, 2F2 actually? F1 and F2, these are representing focus of this lens. Light can come from either side. It can come from left side. It can come from right side also. So that's why we have F1 and F2 as two focus, and this 2F1 and 2F2, these are actually double of focal length. OF is focal length, and O2F2 is double of focal length. Similarly, O2F1, that is also double of focal length. And similarly, we can explain these in case of concave lens.